And hello. The copyright train is over for now. Or is it? Oh, it just started up again. Might be okay, because the microphone's that way. The music's kind of soft right now, and there's other bowling going on. Nope, actually, it's a bit loud. Time for two stink of the bonus balls from that strike. Sorry about the muted audio, but somebody seems to love the jukebox here. So, mute we go again. What will the bonus be? Yeah, look. Okay, they're finally done playing. That's a 7. They're finally done playing with the jukebox. I think. Maybe not. Nope, they decided to put another quarter in. Every time it stops, somebody has to put money in that damn jukebox. Unlike 10 pin, if that pin were to miraculously stand right back up because it fell over, it does count. It's time for El Stinko the bonus ball. What will the bonus be? Yeah, we can mute now. Time for El Stinko the bonus ball. What will the bonus be? Hopefully better than last. El Stinko stinks for the leave, but a six fill is not too bad. Hello, Jack, Chris Allen. Yeah, we got somebody who loves the jukebox, so we can't have the audio playing too much. So back to mute till they decide to not put quarters in the damn thing. If that were only ball two. If El Stinko can give me at least five, we will end with something very rare here at Mason's, a three-digit score. That first ball just barely overline and an uh-oh. And we got a jam. I think they're done with the music. They're not around it. I don't hear anything coming out yet. All right, we had a jam, it's been fixed. Starting game number 5. We've been getting this ball 3 leave quite a bit today. Oh great, they're gonna put some more music on, so that's a 6. Guys making a selection, so let's enjoy this while we can. A kingpin left for a nice out of 9. Maybe he just looked and decided not to put anything in. That'd be good. He's looking at it again. It's a 9. And he did select something. Back to mute. Yep, welcome to Masons. The jukebox bandits are leaving, but there's still a play or two left. Like I said, the music box guys left. There was a play or two still left. Is it finally done? So we can hear stuff going on. Nope, not okay yet. Still got some plays on. I totally forgot I got a spare and do not remember the fill, therefore I will take the penalty of a zero for the fill. Alright, is the jukebox done all the plays those jukebox bandits had left in it? I like to keep the audio on, but the YouTube copyright gods hate anything that's copyrighted in the video. I hear silence. That might be a good thing. Game number 7. I want to look for at least 6 of the 12 to be a good game, 80 or higher. One away from that, half the paper to go. I'm not hearing any more. I think we're good now. Finally, 1 hour 10 minutes into it, we can finally hear what's going on. Start with a 9. So until somebody puts more stuff in there, maybe it came back from Dave and Buster's. Hello, the car wash. Again, Jack, hello. Hello, Chris Allen. All right. And they keep popping up this welcome to live chat crap that I don't need to see, blocking all the views. All right, next frame. Check. That piece of wood that's in front of the horizontal one, the one right there, that one slid forward before it fell forward. So if it, there's a line there, if the pin is touching or past the line, it's considered no good and has to be removed. If it's behind the line, it's good. He's moving away, so it must be all right. Good then?
Yeah.
Spare that one up. All right, it's time for El Stinko, the bonus ball. Notice the yellow coloring. That's so that when I was attempting to qualify for King of the Palace, somebody had the same bowling balls I did, so I colored them the urethane marks yellow so we could tell them apart. El Stinko time. Hopefully good. El Stinko drifted off, but we got a nice 7. When odd things happen, I tend to lose track, and that kind of sucks. When the place is fairly full, it doesn't matter if the jukebox is playing. There's enough noise to mask everything but the bass. So we got an 8. Did that last one have to fall? Yeah, I usually try not to be the hero and go for the easy stuff like that. So that's a 9. Hey, look, it's our friend Bob Kaliri. He's showing his right side, which is the 4 horsemen right and the 8. Very hard to get. I don't know how the microphone is on live streams, because I know when I record video, it lags slightly behind the video. But that ball was just, and I mean just behind the lob line. I let it go a few feet past everyone, because I suck, you know. I'll take the nine. Halftime report. Very false hope halftime report. I'm sure you can figure out what the false hope is. 52 half. That one day I got 400s in a single visit is unbelievable. I rarely ever get hundreds here at Mason's. So 52 at the half. What could have been? Down the toilet this game starts to go. Thank God we got the buffer. Five. Haven't done that in a while. Now we go for what's called the Emily. That's where you miss everything on ball one, get them all on ball two. Hundreds is pretty much gone at this point. We've been under mute for so long, I'm about to flash a nine. I can actually say it now because no one's playing the jukebox. Yeah, hundreds are dead at this point. But then again, Masons. Got robbed of a spare. Anywhere else that would have happened. Still an eight. So last frame and we're already in the good territory. So my goal of at least 6 good games on the sheet, which is half, has been met with 4 games left. Not the pin. If that were only ball 2. 10. All right, final score. Boo. Got screwed out of a spare. And at least one, I wish it was ball 2 moment. 92, which again, for Mason's and my ability, not bad. Not bad at all. Game number 8 of 12. And I've been flashing this often, so I'll just state it now. High single, 139, not done here. Low of 44, was done here. When I started bowling the right way without something in the other hand. And my Mason's record, which we probably will never see again, 121. The closest we got today was a 98, game number 8. Horsemen are drawing nearer. Upon the scene they ride, coming to take your strike. And an 8. And again, I want to express in Candlepin and even duck pin for the third ball. If you want to risk being a hero, go for everything. Otherwise, go for the easy points like I tried to do with those 2 over there. So that's an 8. It is what it is. It's a 7. Again, because of the long mute, I was about to flash a 10. I can just tell you, 10. wait for the wood to settle down. Set up nicely, watch me go way to the side. That's a signal of spare, but this time it didn't go to the side. All know what time it is. It's time for El Stinko, the bonus ball. What will the bonus be? Last one wasn't too bad and left something favorable that I blew. El Stinko lives up to its name with a two. Second shot was a bit pathetic. It was a little too full, but thankfully the wood kind of made it less pathetic. That's a nine. And it's time for the halftime report. Don't you like the back lighting? Actually, it's more front lighting. Not too bad. We're at a 46 half. So let's see how the second half goes. Again. Let minor lobs live. If that was behind, if it was past the line, I couldn't really tell. Kingpin remains for the nine. Spare. We all know what that means. It's time for El Stinko, the bonus ball. Last one was a two. What will this one be? It helps, but El Stinko was a bit weak with a four. Curse of the fill, a six. All right, to hit the bottom end of average, you just need 5 points amongst two frames, and I haven't said this because of the muting. Under ICBA records, casual league bowlers, which is a step above what I am, average between 80 to 100, 90 pretty much is the middle there. So 80 to 100 is pretty good. 100 here is, hey, going to Disney World practically. All right, 2 frames, 5 points. Going for the Emily, which is a spare. Nothing in ball one, everything in ball two. Half Worcester, 3 to go. Stink frame of two, well, maybe we won't make it. There we go, the opposite of what we need. There's three standing, we needed 3 down. Yeah, the 9 pins behind there. Anywhere else that would have went, but that wasn't exactly the spot to hit it. That one fell out of my hand, 9er. Final. Boo. At least we got an 86. So that's 7 out of 12. Slightly better than what I want. Still 4 games to go. Let's play it. I was doing the wrong thing and trying to be a hero, hit the head pin. Thankfully it failed. Give us an 8. You know those three words? Say it with me and I know there will be a lag. Welcome to Masons. That's an 8. Thank you. distinct frame of four. Interesting 10.
She's good. She's great. She's bad. That's a great one. Oh, it's a great one. Oh, whoa. Shut it down. Go, 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 go.
Yeah, that spear should help out. Halftime report. Boo. There's a joke in there, obviously. So far we have at least a 40 with El Stinko, the bonus ball to fill in the spare, to see what the half truly winds up being. El Stinko doing what it's very good at doing, a 2. Making the half of 42. Seven. We got that favorable piece of wood right there. If we can hit that 3-pin. Battery's almost fully recovered. Who threw the ball to sweep? A wise-ass kid, that's who. All right. Ball 2. That was supposed to be ball 2, but we'll take 10. Thank you. Second ball was a little too thin. Niner. We squeaked in there with a five. Still an 81 out of that. All right, game 10. 8 of the 12 are good. Start with eight. That's the second one today. First one was done under silence. Two Elstinko the bonus balls. What will they add up to? Can I get a double? It's only happened in three places. Putnam Street, which is probably the world's easiest candlepin house. Acton Bullidrome, they juice the damn pin plate. And of all places, a tough house like Brian's Bowlaway, which if you're not familiar with, which a lot of people in the candlepin circuit aren't, if you know how Riverwalk plays, you got an idea of how Brian's Bowlaway and Gardner plays. All right, can we get one of the world's toughest houses a double?
No.
El Nopo. But a nine. Spare and strike, definitely take that. Time for Elstinko the bonus ball. Nice effort on the double strike. Thank you, Watson. Then again, it's Mason's. That is pretty damn good. So let's see what Elstinko gives us.
I have a box cutter in my car.
The leaves a little questionable, but a 7 fill ain't bad. In just 3 frames, I beat my low of 44. Two marks in a row. I have a feeling there's a great collapse at the end. Actually, that's 3 marks in a row, and in candlepin bowling, if you simply mark 3 times in a row, it's considered a turkey. So I'll stink of the bonus ball again. Let's see what we get. Wow, well, stinko stinks for the leave, but if I hit that 4 pin just right, I could probably get another spare. That's an 8 fill. Take a 9. Believe it or not, at Mason's, what you're about to see is the halftime report, not the end of the game. Halftime. If this game does not wind up 80 or better, something went horribly wrong. Now I will bring up, I'm not betting that I'll get the high of 139, especially here. The Mason's high of 121, maybe. Maybe. So let's see how the second half goes. That's an 8. We should get at least a 3-digit score, which is very rare here. .80 with 4 frames left. Whatever, take 9. Thank you. Nice 10. All right, I need one pin for 3 digits. If I can't get this in the last 2 frames, there's something really wrong. Staring at a Starlight 5 and a 3-digit score, very rare at Mason's. Anywhere else that would have went. Take a niner. Yeah, no new Mason's high, but hey, great one. As advertised, every time I get hot, the great collapse occurs, and there it is, 6. Well, here's what the great collapse has given us. Boo. The rest was actually okay. 114. Can't complain about that, that's for sure. Now the question is, how's the great collapse gonna continue? Sometimes it goes away before this next game. Sometimes it lingers. Game 11. Let's see how it goes. Dreaded great collapse is stuck, still going on with a 6. Is a lot better. Thank you. Niner. Have a piece of wood behind the four horsemen. We gotta wait for it to settle, and it did. We'll take 10. Can't wish for being ball two. I think we made the great collapse last very short, but it still had an effect. We're still okay with a 41 half. That. Then that from the previous game. As soon as I speak, it all goes to hell. 7. And a spare to help true things up a bit. Zeffirel Stenko, the bonus ball. What will the bonus be? They've been kind of all over the place. The four horsemen left and a buddy behind it known as pin number 8. Halfway decent 5 fill. And an 8. Yep, 8. 2 frames need at least 9. Thank you. The collapse continues. That's a 7. Two pins. Oh, we know we've done less than that before. Squeaked into the good territory again. Oh, look at the better. Don't think that's going to do much. Take an 8. Alrighty. Actually didn't turn out halfway decent. Got an 86. And of course Mason's not bad. Last and final game. Looks like we've partially recovered from the collapse. Doing the job. Final game. We got at least 10 of the 12. Let's see if we can make it 11. Before I play the final game, you might be wondering, why am I doing the live bowling on a Friday? Snowstorm Saturday. Depending on what you listen to, it's either minor, a mild snowstorm, a big one, or nothing. All right, number 10, number 12. Dreaded high-low jack. Got some help with some wood. There is a video of me from Academy Lanes when it was a lot easier the first time I was there, where I actually made it with no wood assist, even though there was a piece of wood in the gutter. Had no effect. Let's see if I can get at least one. Got them all with a wood assist for a 10. Must emphasize high-low jack with the wood attempt. Oh, look, it's Bob Kaleri again, forceman right in the 8. Again, I went for the most points and not try to be the hero. It kind of worked out with an 8. take another eight. Bowling God's middle finger for the nine. Yeah, we kind of collapsed. Although the score isn't terribly bad. 42 half. It's Mason's, it's not going. Ten. Netter 10. Well, there's Bob Cleary again. Right side, four horsemen. And the eight. Exactly like last time. Not exactly like last time. Niner. Nine pins in two frames. We know we've seen bad ones, so it's possible to blow it. But I think it'll be done. Cherry picked the way through seven. Just need two. That's more than two. Pick an end with a spare and an El Stinko. Thank you. That's a 9. There we have it. I haven't been looking at this. I owe Jack at least one, eh? I've done it with no wood before. Nice effort on double strike yet. Sharp in game 10 indeed. In fact, hey Jack, just in time for the end. That is, there's the end. Hello Windy City, too bad you're too late. 87. Yeah, this is the one right here. Game 10. 8 strikes, blah, blah, blah. 114. All right, let's look at them. 182. 86. The low point. Game 3, 79. 498. 582. 686. 792. 886. 981. The highlight. Game 10. 114. 7 away from my high at this place. 86 and 87 for 11 and 12. All 4 of my balls came back. They've been only 3 quite often. Glad the fourth one came back. Otherwise, I have to throw some, knock some pins down, and hope it comes back. At this place, sometimes they actually hop into the mechanics areas behind the pit, and they have to retrieve it. Not this time. So that'll be it for this Friday instead of Saturday edition of live Candlepin Bowling from Mason's, because I was gonna go to Putnam's, but they had leagues on Fridays. I would think they would have it open because kids would be out of school and would have not on Fridays once they get out, of course. Apparently not. So again, Mason's, and this time a lot better. When will your next live bowling be? Not sure. I typically try to do them every Saturday if it's possible. Today, because there's an impending possible snowstorm of some degree, it's being done today. So that'll be it. 11 out of 12, and the worst one being a 79, the high a 114. Georgia551 saying, hope you enjoyed, have a good one, and sometimes I trick myself to thinking I'm getting better at this.